A girlfriend who accepts me as who I am. I've come to love her even more. I strongly promised myself to make her happy, no matter what. My name's Jake, 28 years old. Born to kind-hearted parents, I had an average school life, and now I'm a regular office worker. The company I work for has a wonderful working condition. They pay for overtime work, give regular breaks, and have solid benefits. You might think I have no worries, but even I have some issues. It's about my body shape. I have a naturally large frame. Overweight, well actually, I'm also tall and have a big build, so I'm more like a cuddly bear. Being big isn't a problem, the issue is the gap between my appearance and my personality. Embarrassingly, I'm timid. I get scared easily and can be jumpy. Absolutely no horror movies or roller coasters for me. And while people think I must love meat and eat a lot, beef doesn't sit well with me. I like rice just as much as average guy. Sweets, like cake and chocolate, are my favorite. I can't even drink black coffee. In our modern day, people say we all have different values, but people judge based on appearance anyway. My ex once dumped me, saying she thought I'd be more manly. That was back in college. I was never good with women, and being dumped like that left a huge scar. I ended up growing distant from women. As a result, I'm still single at 28. I've been set up on dates by co-workers and friends quite a few times. But conversations never really took off, and nothing progressed. I hadn't found a woman I truly felt connected with since college, so I thought I was okay with that. But now, there's a woman I've been interested in. At my workplace, I was assigned to a newly established department 6 months ago. The department, made up of relatively younger folks within the company, was still small and had yet to make any achievements. But everyone is full of enthusiasm to make results and expand this new department, and I feel very fulfilled doing my part. The woman I have a crush on is Jessica, who became the boss in this new department. Despite being 34, she was given a significant role in this new setup, a real successful career-driven woman. Not only is she competent at her job, but she's also gorgeous with an outstanding figure. She's even been featured in the company newsletter, making her a bit of a celebrity around the office. But what makes her truly wonderful isn't her looks or skills, but her social and friendly personality. In a department dominated by men, Jessica always communicates proactively, which is improving the office teamwork. For some reason, she seems to pay special attention to me. "Jake, I've got a snack for you again today. Here you go." She always gives me snacks. I often get invited to lunch too. Strangely, Jessica seems to only invite me to lunch. "Hey, are you, by any chance, dating Jessica?" I've been asked this by my colleagues more times than I can count. Once, I asked her, "Why do you always invite me for lunch? I'm not the best at making conversation, and wouldn't you have more fun with others?" "Oh, are you feeling pressured? It's hard to decline an invite from a boss, right? I'm so sorry," she quickly said, and I hastily denied. "No, that's not it. I mean, I'm grateful, but I always wonder why you care about someone like me. I'm not particularly skilled at work, and there are great-looking seniors and peers around, so I wonder why you always reach out to me." Hearing my lack of confidence, Jessica softly smiled and replied, "It's not just about who gets the best results at work. We're a team, Jake. You are always there supporting everyone. That's why I and everyone else feel comfortable working with you. I know other good things about you. Be confident." Honestly, hearing that from someone I had feelings for made me incredibly happy. But I didn't have any intentions of confessing my feelings to Jessica. To me, she seemed like someone who was out of my league. Maybe she cares about me because the needy ones are the cutest, or something like that. Just being around her Seeing her and talking to her was enough to satisfy me, that's what I thought. However, soon there was an event that changed my perspective. One time, I had to go on a business trip out of state with Jessica. The overnight trip, which we were taking by train, was initially planned for Jessica and another senior colleague. But the day before, that colleague fell sick. There was talk of Jessica going alone, but last minute, they decided to let me accompany her for experience. Being my first business trip in the new department, and especially with Jessica, I was pretty nervous. Perhaps noticing my anxiety, Jessica tried to ease my tension by striking up a conversation on the train, and even gave me some time to relax when I looked tired. I was reminded again how considerate and kind she is. That day, I planned to stay in a hotel, while Jessica was planning to stay at her parents' house. Turns out the business location was near Jessica's hometown, so she had taken off from work the next day. By the way, anticipating the fatigue from the trip, I had also been granted leave for the following day. So, our plan was to head back leisurely on an afternoon train. However, after finishing our work, something unexpected happened. While walking close to my hotel, Jessica suddenly sat down. Apparently, she suffers from anemia sometimes. As she sat, she looked pale and said she felt dizzy. I thought of taking her to a hospital, but after she took her meds, Jessica assured me I'll be okay soon and insisted we didn't need to go. I'll take a taxi to my parents' house from here, Jake. You can head back to the hotel. It's okay, she said, but I was too worried to let her go alone. I got into the taxi with her, deciding to drop her off at her parents' house. I was supposed to head back right after that, or at least that was the plan. But the moment we arrived at Jessica's parents' house, everything changed. I held Jessica's bags and supported her as we stood at the front door of her family's home. When I rang the doorbell of the two-story American-style house, two younger men, who looked strikingly similar to each other, came out. Both of them shouted in unison, "Mom, Jessica brought a guy home." Before I could even react, I heard the hustle and bustle from inside, and several people, both men and women, rushed out. "Oh my, Jessica, when did you get a boyfriend? Why didn't you tell us? We're not prepared at all. Sister-in-law's boyfriend is a big guy, huh?" While I was in shock, Jessica, having a headache, whispered, "No, he's not," she tried to explain, but then three kids, Jack, Leo, and Sam, came running to the door. "Auntie, you're so late. Let's play. Come on. Draw something for us. Draw." Clearly, the kids weren't interested in our story. Feeling overwhelmed by everyone talking at once, an older man, about my size, came from the back and let out a sigh. "Everyone, please calm down. At least let them in." With this atmosphere, I couldn't say, "I'll just head out now." So, I was warmly welcomed and ended up stepping inside Jessica's family home. Feeling unwell, Jessica decided to rest upstairs, and I was invited into their huge living room. That was where I was introduced to everyone. And boy, that introduction was just something else. Living in Jessica's family home was her father, named Tyler, her mother Chelsea, Jessica's twin younger brothers, a younger sister named Mason, grandparents, and even a great-grandmother. Adding to that, because Jessica had returned home after a long time, her older brother, Kevin, and his wife Lena, their three kids, and a close family friend, who seemed to be the boyfriend of another sister, had also came over for dinner. So, on this day, there was a total of 14 people at Jessica's house. Growing up as an only child, I was used to a quiet and calm household. Well, this was also because both my parents and I were not very talkative. And thus, the atmosphere at Jessica's house was so overwhelming for me. Not only was there a big family, but each one talked nonstop, like a machine gun firing away. Moreover, everyone would just start talking, regardless of whether someone else was already speaking. I felt like I had to be some kind of superhuman to keep up with them all. For my part, I was desperately trying to explain, I'm not her boyfriend. I'm just a coworker. You don't have to be shy about it. How long have you two been dating? Was the kind of thing they kept asking, not listening to a word I said. I felt hopeless. However, they weren't bad people. Proof of that was the endless stream of food and drinks they brought out. By that time, I had completely missed my chance to return to my hotel. Then, Jessica, who had been resting upstairs, came down to the first floor. Whether the medicine had worked or resting helped, Jessica's complexion had improved. Seeing me being bombarded with questions, Jessica sighed deeply. "Oh, Jake, I'm so sorry," she said. Jessica then explained to her family that I was just a co-worker, and I had given her a ride home because she felt ill. Jessica's family seemed disappointed to find out I wasn't her boyfriend, but they quickly adjusted. "Whether you're a co-worker or not, you're still our guest. Is there anything you don't like to eat? You're staying over, right? Well, I was thinking of staying at a hotel, and there's no worry for my dinner. I can grab something at a convenience store or something," I replied. But the adults insisted on having a drink and chat, and the kids kept asking me to stay, saying, "You have to stay over." Feeling pressured, I finally called the hotel to cancel my reservation. Jessica leaned over and whispered apologetically in my ear, "I'm really sorry. Are you okay with this?" Even though Jessica said that, the truth was, I was starting to enjoy this place. While having some drinks and food, I'd really warmed up to everyone. I'm not great at talking with women, but the men in this house were quite chatty and made it fun to converse. And while I might be a bit shy, I've always loved lively atmospheres. Being an only child, I've always dreamed of big families. Everyone here is pretty assertive, but they're also hilarious, and Jessica's mom makes some delicious food. Plus, Jessica's twin brothers, Brandon and Kyle, are 26, close to my age, so we got along. No, it's my first time in such a lively setting, but I'm starting to have fun. I'm the one who should apologize, staying over at my boss's family home like this. No, I'm glad you're here. My family's a bit loud, but if you're enjoying yourself, then it's worth it. I couldn't help but think that perhaps Jessica's considerate personality came from this family background. As the night went on and more drinks were poured, Brandon and Kyle brought out an old photo album of Jessica's childhood. Looking through it, I wondered how unexpected this whole situation was. Going on a business trip with my attractive boss to her hometown and ending up coming close with her family. Even though it was an unexpected event, seeing how pleased Jessica seemed with me bonding with her family made me glad that I came here. Lost in these thoughts, Tyler, who had been in the bathroom, returned. "How far have you guys gotten?" To which, Brandon responded, "We just talked about when Jessica finished elementary school." A tipsy Tyler, along with Brandon and Kyle, have been telling me various stories from Jessica's childhood. "Oh, right, right. Mind if I continue? You're not bored, are you?" To be honest, I suspected the stories from the older guys were a bit exaggerated, but they were darn entertaining. "I'm all ears." I was eager to hear more. "Stop talking about embarrassing stuff, okay?" Jessica blushed, a sight of her I'd never seen at the office, and it was something new. Even then, the family revolved around the stories about Jessica, and eventually, Tyler, perhaps was too tipsy, dozed off. I noticed others, including the children, had gone to bed. In the kitchen, I could see Jessica and the eldest son's wife was starting to clean up. Catching a glimpse of Jessica in an apron, an image I'd never be able to see in the office, I couldn't help but feel a surge of excitement. But as Brandon observed me, he whispered to me with a smirk on his face, "You have a crush for my sister, don't you? It's so obvious." "What? No, I mean..." While I blushed in panic, Kyle also chimed in, whispering, "Just spill the beans. Maybe Jessica feels..." "Nah, maybe I shouldn't give it away." After they teased me enough, the two brothers headed to their rooms upstairs. I was left alone in the living room, pondering over Brandon and Kyle's words. I had chosen not to confess my feelings, but what if Jessica felt the same way about me? I tried to keep calm, but memories of the photographs and Jessica's life journey filled my mind. Jessica has always been deeply loved by her family. I thought, if I could be loved by someone like her, I'd be truly blessed. Encouraged by Brandon and Kyle's hints, I began to feel some courage. I felt that if I missed this moment, I might never find the nerve again. So, once the cleaning was done and Jessica returned from the kitchen, I mustered the courage and confessed my feelings. I've liked you for a long time now. I always felt you were out of my league. I thought I should just give up, but I couldn't. I want to become someone special for you. Jessica was clearly surprised by my sudden confession, and her cheeks soon turned red. Do you remember asking me why I was always caring about you? When I first saw you, I thought you were like my father, big in stature, but kind-hearted inside. However, during a business gathering, I overheard you talking about how your size was an insecurity for you. That's when I felt the urge to cheer you up. Indeed, I always felt self-conscious about my large frame and timid personality. I thought you shouldn't feel that way. You always step up for the physical works at the office, right? And you offer to help out with chores, always with a smile. Initially, I just wished you'd have more confidence, but before I knew it, I found myself caring about you more and more. I had no idea she had noticed all those little things about me. My heart was racing, and my palms were sweaty. But when I looked into Jessica's eyes, they were glistening and wavering. I wasn't the only one who was nervous. She took a deep breath and said, "It was me who has liked you from the beginning. If you're okay with it, would you date me?" Holding back my urge to jump in joy, I took her hand and replied, "Yes, yes. Thank you so much," bowing my head. But remembering how sweaty my hands were, I tried to pull away, yet Jessica held on tightly, making it impossible to let go. I still remember the happiness I felt over such a small thing. The next day, after announcing our relationship to Jessica's entire family, they seemed ready to throw a party, despite it being early morning. We managed to avoid that, but I was overjoyed by how warmly her family accepted me. After saying our goodbyes to Jessica's family, we took the same Amtrak train home. Sitting next to each other, we sneakily held hands. It felt like I was a teenager again, and also a bit embarrassing. Just holding hands made my heart race like crazy. She's truly a beautiful person, and a year into our relationship, we got married. Our wedding was lively with Jessica's family in full attendance. During the ceremony, I found myself reminiscing. Me, with my big, bear-like physique, and my stunning boss, Jessica. Despite our differences, we became closer. Thinking back to the business trip to her hometown, everything happened so fast. As I recalled this, a performance started by Jessica's siblings, making everyone laugh till they nearly rolled over. At the same time, realizing I was becoming a part of this wonderful family lifted my spirits. Whether it was happiness or amusement, or both, tears streamed down my face. "You're crying already," said Jessica, wiping away my tears, dressed in a beautiful white wedding gown. Jessica's beauty was so blinding that it only made me tear up more. Seeing this, even Jessica's brothers and father couldn't help but tear up themselves. "Jessica, I'm sorry for crying so much. I'm just so happy and grateful. Thank you for making me a part of such an amazing family. I know I'm emotional, but I promise I'll be a strong man. Just let me cry for today." As I sniffled, Jessica gently wiped my eyes with a handkerchief and said, "It's okay for you to be a crybaby. I'll always be here to wipe away your tears." She accepts me for who I am. I might have married an angel. That's genuinely how I felt, and it was the best day of my life.